Hi, in this video, we'll give you a brief introduction on how to use the mixing window with videos, videos with audio attached, and photos. A lot of the functionality covered in mixing window part 1 audio works the same for videos and photos, so we highly recommend watching part 1 first. So let's start by adding some video to the mixing window. I can find and preview my videos and photos in the media browser, and simply drag and drop them into the mixing screen. The first thing I'd like to do is to draw your attention to the target frame size when editing video and photos in the mixing screen. Ideally, you should firstly select the target frame size, as this will dictate where the borders and frame dimensions will be set for your mix when in the video output screen and resulting exported file. For example, if I want to make a video for YouTube, I can click on the target frame size and select YouTube HD. Your video will be displayed in the video output screen and YouTube with the correct aspect ratio. You will also notice that some frame size are shown in bold. These selections shown in bold require specific encoding parameters and templates that are known to work for these selections. An important note, if you create a mix in a target frame size and thereafter change the target frame size to a different aspect ratio, the relative position of your files in relation to each other as viewed in the video output screen may change. So let's go back to the mixing screen. When you drag a file into the mixing screen, you'll notice the video with audio will be presented on two separate tracks. An important note here is when video with audio is brought into the mixing window, the audio will automatically be disabled from the global tempo and will play at its normal speed. However, if you've created a video and photo mix and bring an audio file to use as a soundtrack, you must click on the Disable Beat Syncing icon if you wish the audio to play at its normal detected BPM and not be bound to the global tempo. I'll now discuss the track name and properties section. The track properties for audio are covered in Mixing Window Part 1, so I'll start with the track properties for the video channel. The first icon you will notice is the Mute Video Track icon. This will simply mute all the video from playing on this track. The next icon we have is Solo the Track. When pressed, only this track will play. However, you can have multiple tracks soloed. Next we have the Video Brightness Envelope icon. This envelope allows you to adjust the brightness on the track using the envelope. The final icons we have are Always on Top and Collage, which work together with each other. Collaging allows you to have multiple videos and images in the same output screen, and is covered in detail in the Collage video. Again, you can adjust the height of the track and minimize it, and expand or decrease the width. To remove a track, click on the Remove Track icon in the track name. When the video is in the mixing screen, I am able to adjust the length of the video using the Adjust Length indicators. When adjusting the video in length, you'll notice the green and red loop graphic, which indicates the start and end of the video loop. If you drag on, the segment will be repeated. You will also notice the indents at the end of the file, indicating you're at the end of the segment, and if I drag on, the segment will be repeated. You can also move an individual segment by clicking on it to highlight it, and click and hold to move it to its new location. If you'd like to move both or multiple segments, you can use the Auto Selection tool to highlight the segments, and click and hold to move them to their new location. Just to note, a video track cannot be placed on an audio track, and vice versa. Also, using the Auto Selection tool, you can group multiple segments together. This is explained in greater detail in the grouping video. As mentioned in part 1, we've added the ability to snap segments, which allows for precise placement of your segments. This is also a great way of keeping your video files with audio in sync, as they will snap together if resized or moved. If I move my second segment on channel 3 and place it beside the first segment, you'll notice it will snap to the first segment and a blue arrow will appear indicating it is placed directly beside it. If I move the segment further onto the first segment, it will begin to crossfade. You can also introduce fades at the beginning and end of your segments. If you right click on the crossfades and fades, you can introduce fade types and transitions. Click on the automatic crossfading icon to turn this feature off. To learn more about crossfading and fades, please see the crossfading video. I can also snap and align my segment to other segments and tracks above and below it. Again, this is indicated by blue arrows in the top and bottom corners. You can also move tracks to different positions within the mixing screen to facilitate easy segment snapping for all your segments. To turn this feature off, click on the segment snapping icon. Also, as mentioned in part 1, is the ability to zoom in and out of the mixing window using the scroll wheel on your mouse. You can also use the play bar to scrub through your audio and video, allowing for more precise painting and editing. The last feature we will show you works well with both audio and video. The split segment function allows you to split your segment into two or more separate segments. This is a really nice feature if you'd like to create two different segments from the same file and change the properties of each segment, like altering their play rate to speed one up or to introduce a slow-mo.